Hi, I'm Chris Whitney with Progressive Crane. If you're wondering about the different types of overhead cranes and what applications need them, you've come to the right place. Welcome to Cranes 101. If you've done your research or watched our previous video, What is an Overhead Crane? You've already learned about what an overhead crane can do to increase productivity and safety within your plant. But with so many different types of cranes, you may find yourself struggling to find out which type fits your application and your business. That's where I come in. Since no two cranes are alike, we'd like to use our 40 plus years of experience to help you choose the appropriate crane for your application to help your business. From the high power bridge crane to the everyman's workstation crane, we'll discuss the strengths and weaknesses of each type. We will also discuss the differences in common types of cranes, top running versus under running, single girder versus double girder, and how each one suits certain needs. Our goal is to help establish a deeper understanding of overhead cranes so that you can use that information in choosing an overhead crane that will benefit your business. Are you ready? Let's go. So, what is an overhead bridge crane? If you remember from our last video, it's that machine you keep losing money on trying to win your data stuffed animal, or the machine that Sid from Toy Story used to win a rubber alien. The bridge crane system consists of two overhead rails connected by a single or double girder bridge. The bridge is supported by an end truck that rides on top of the rails and moves your bridge from one end of the runway to the other. So let's start by unpacking the single girder versus double girder argument. So why use one over the other? It really depends on your application and your budget. A single girder crane consists of a single beam with a hoist trolley riding on the lower flange. Typically, these are less expensive due to lower freight costs, easier installation, a more simpler hoist design, and also allows for a lighter runway beam. The main reason you would want to upgrade from a single girder to a double girder crane is if the capacity you're lifting is over 15 tons or you need to have a higher hook height within your existing space. If you wanted to, you can engineer a single girder crane to go to a higher capacity or for a wider span, but the higher you go, the less cost effective it is to use a single girder crane and you'll want to pursue a double girder. Double girder systems use two bridge beams instead of one. Typically, you'll see a double girder crane used for higher capacities, wider spans, and also higher duty cycles. In addition, if you have specialty equipment or need a service platform, you also want to take a look at a double girder crane. On a top running design, they also provide a better hook height since the hoist is running on top of the beams instead of on the lower flange. Okay, so do I need a top running or an under running crane? Again, what's your application? Top running cranes have no limiting capacity. They can be used for very small loads to very heavy. They are ideal for heavy lifting applications. Underrunning cranes, otherwise known as underhung cranes, ride on the lower flange of the runway beam. These types of cranes are typically designed for lighter capacity and lighter duty cycle. However, they're designed to maximize your building space as they're hung from the ceiling and don't have any column that reach the floor. In addition, the hoist can travel further across the bridge and also along the runway, which gives you greater hook travel. When we talk about underrunning cranes, we have two different types of bridge girder beams we can use. You have structural steel shapes, and then you also have patented track. Structural steel is rolled from a softer, mild steel and is typically used for lighter duty cycle applications. Patented track, however, is engineered and built from a stronger steel and is used for higher duty cycle applications. So enough about the beams. Let's get back into the cranes. Do you need a process crane or do you need a modular crane? Process cranes are built for a specific need. Typically, they're at a higher capacity in a steel mill or a container yard, and you see those lifting 10 to 20 lifts per hour at 50 to 75% of the rated capacity. CMAA typically rates these at a class D, E, or F. A modular crane, or more commonly known as a kit crane, is typically used in a machine shop or a small mill environment. These types of cranes are more economical and affordable. CMAA rates them at a class C or below because they're only used 5 to 10 times per hour and at roughly 40% of the capacity of the crane. If needed, extra engineering can bump it up to a class D. So a bridge crane doesn't sound right for you. Lucky for you, we've got other options. Gantry cranes are similar to an overhead bridge, except for they don't have overhead rail to run on. They have two legs that run on embedded rail in the floor or can also run on top of the concrete. Gantry cranes are typically used in an outdoor environment in a rail yard or a shipyard where overhead supports are not available. In addition, they can be used inside when overhead obstructions prevent the use of an overhead crane. First type of gantry crane that I want to talk about is a portable gantry. This is typically used in a maintenance or a warehousing application where there's lifts required in different areas of the plant. There are two types of portable gantry cranes. You have adjustable and fixed. First type, adjustable, allows you to raise and lower the boom depending on overhead obstructions in a certain area of your plant. A fixed height gantry, the boom is in a single position and does not move up or down. The other type of gantry crane is a track mounted gantry. This is similar to a bridge crane in that it only moves in a single plane. Again, you'll have a hoist trolley that is mounted on there that gives you the same types of motions, but it is mounted on the floor. In addition to portable and track mounted gantries, I also want to talk about engineered gantries. These are a more permanent fixture in that they have rail that is mounted to the floor and can also be tied to an overhead crane runway. Monorail cranes are used in an assembly line or production line. Typically, these are used when you don't need any side-to-side motion and you just want to stick to a single plane. In addition, they can also be used to move materials from one bay into another by way of a track switch. These are perfect for when a full-blown overhead crane is not needed. Jib cranes come in a number of different types and sizes. They're typically used when an overhead crane and runway system is not available. You have a freestanding, or you can have one mounted off of a column. These come in a number of different capacities and spans depending on your need. A jib crane can also give you a range of 180 degree rotation to 360 degrees. Not sure if a jib crane is the right application for you? Consider the following. What kind of floor space do you have? What is the capacity and the usage? Can we mount it off of a column? What other special options or considerations are required? What is your budget for the project? The more information you have, the better suited you are to make a decision. Workstation cranes are designed for an individual user. They can be ceiling hung or freestanding. With a rated capacity of 250 pounds to 2 tons, the key here is that the user can ergonomically move a load from one end of a system to the other. And that's it. It's up to you to consider the following. How many cranes do you need? What is the capacity of the crane and the hoist? How many lifts per hour? And what percentage of capacity are each lift being performed? Also, you'll want to consider span, hook height, existing runway, operating conditions for the crane, or any other special considerations. Progressive Crane is a leading manufacturer of world-class overhead cranes. With over 40 years of experience, we engineer and build customer solutions using all the cranes that we discussed. Our capabilities range from light-duty, light-capacity applications to high-duty cycle, high-capacity overhead cranes. If you're interested in learning how overhead cranes can increase the efficiency and safety within your facility or to schedule a crane consultation, please contact us and we will get you in touch with one of our crane specialists. For all of us at Progressive Crane, I'm Chris Whitney. Thank you for watching Cranes 101.